One of the things that I've noticed in the transition is that every day I have so many demands that I'm faced with, and I have to decide which ones I'm going to be the highest priority, which ones are maybe going to have to wait, and knowing that I can't necessarily do everything the way I want to do it every day.
As a teacher, one of the things that you have the luxury of is being kind of in control of your own environment, and you can kind of plan your day. You have routines, and you don't have that luxury when you're doing the vice principal's job. Every day is different, every situation is different. It's hard to plan out exactly what your day is going to look like.
I guess the most challenging part was just, you know, the school, the workings of the school day, so dealing with buses and dealing with discipline and all those things that I wasn't accustomed to doing in my role, my previous role.
The amount of things that I've done in a day, if I were to write them down, I would never believe that I was able to get through. And just kind of accepting that you're never going to be finished.
They give you lots of training as to, you know, what to expect, and then when you actually hit the ground running, you realize that they couldn't possibly prepare you for everything that you deal with on a day-to-day basis, but you do have a foundation with which to work from, and that's sort of, you know, you realize, you know, when you spring into action that you've been taught and trained how to do it, you're just not prepared because you don't do it every day in the same sense.
You know, going from that mindset of sort of mastery of something to being really, you know, confused a lot of the time, which before, you know, for the past few years as a consultant, I was pretty confident in what I was doing. Now I don't feel that way anymore.
For myself, the biggest challenge I had was I'm in two schools. Each day is different at each school, and I'm not there the day before, so I have to do a lot of investigating as to what happened the previous day and figure out what happened. So that was the biggest adjustment for me, is trying to get used to the fact that I have two different staffs, two different schools, two different sets of goals, and two different student populations.
I'm finding it so busy because I'm learning all the administration things, and yet I still have the teaching duties. And I'm getting kind of a sampling of the role, because I don't get the whole context. I see a student one day, but I don't know what happened the rest of the day. Or when things are going on in the office, I see some of it, but I can't really follow up because I've got to go to the classroom. So it's been interesting. It's been a steep learning curve. I'm enjoying it. It's exciting.
Something that I would definitely continue to work on is building relationships with other administrators, particularly other new vice principals.
I think job shadowing, or shadowing the vice principal as a teacher, becomes crucial. To be there, to be the lead teacher in the school, teacher in charge, get as much exposure and experience as you can, because soon enough you will be in that role.
One thing that I find a bit difficult that I wish I could change is the amount that I'm actually teaching in the classroom. I love the teaching and it's been a great transition, but I'm finding it difficult to balance the amount of teaching that I'm doing with learning the job as a vice principal and then balancing the home life as well.
Well, I make sure I work in my plans that I get out to visit at least one classroom a day so that they see me as person and not just as administrator.
One of the big things that I found that has made the job really rewarding is that as a facilitator, you come into a school or you come into a triad or a hub and you deliver the message, you deliver the new content, you share sort of what best practice is, and then you leave. And it's up to the administrators in the building to make sure that that takes place. And as the administrator now in the building, it's my job to make sure that what we've talked about and what we've been learning about makes it to the classroom desk.
And one of the biggest transitions for me has been coming from the curriculum department in our school board, working in a variety of schools and seeing excellent practices and trying to not jump into every single change that I want to make right away.
The teachers are fantastic, although many of them have to see me in a different role now, and that's something new for me, is I'm in a totally different role. I'm not working with them. I am now that instructional leader, and for many it's working, and for others it's going to take a little bit of time for people to realize that.
Big piece of advice I'd give to people is just to be flexible. And try not to be reactionary. I mentioned that you do have to react to situations, but you are part of a team, and you don't have to always respond right away. Sometimes it's okay to tell people, you know what, let me think about that, or let me look into that, and I'll get back to you in an hour or so.
I found it very wonderful, that relationship that I'm able to build with the entire community, not just the children, but also the parents and the other staff. And they really do look up to you. And for me, I would say I have to keep that moral focus of where the school is going, that vision, where the school is going, and have all these other people buying into that vision.